Hello. If you're familiar with Synology, it's quite likely you've already begun deploying some type of hybrid cloud architecture in your IT environment. Synology has always been an advocate of bringing all the hardware, software, and data storage solutions that your business relies on into one hybrid structure. And with DSM-7, we're going to be taking the hybrid cloud to a whole new level. Before we talk about some of the specific solutions on the horizon, let's take a second and discuss the pros and cons of both on-prem and cloud-based storage solutions. With on-prem solutions, you will have absolute self-governance of your data security. When it comes to privacy, on-prem is definitely the best choice. In terms of performance, you'll only be limited by your local area network. So if you need fast processing, if you need fast editing, fast access, local hardware is definitely the best solution. And in terms of affordability, I think we all know in the long run, it's always cheaper to own than it is to rent. Synology hardware can save your business tens, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars in its lifespan. On the flip side, having cloud-based architectures, there's no initial IT investment, meaning you don't have to have all of that acquisition, all of that setup, all that deployment. You simply purchase a plan and begin configuring the software. Also, when it comes to remote access, particularly in these times of work from home, being able to log in as an employee or connect multiple locations can be very simple with cloud-based solutions. You're avoiding the complexity of local VPNs. And when it comes to scaling a cloud-based deployment, it's as simple as upgrading your plan, adding more users, or scaling up your capacity just by placing an order. You don't need to touch the hardware. So you can see there's definitely some advantages to both platforms. And at Synology, we believe by creating a hybrid cloud, you can pick and choose the solution and architect the solution that's best for your business's specific needs. We'll talk about the hybrid cloud in three main sections today. First, we'll address the storage component, putting usable data in the cloud and accessing it on site. Then we'll discuss user authentication and signing services. And finally, we'll take a look at monitoring your entire hardware deployment via cloud management. Now, each of these corresponds to a new Synology software that's being released. C2 Hybrid Share will allow you to store data in the Synology C2 cloud and synchronize portions of that data to your local NAS. C2 Directory will provide a hybrid authentication directory service that runs both in the cloud and locally. An Active Insight will give you a bird's eye view of your entire Synology deployment through a streamlined cloud portal. Let's talk about hybrid share. The concept behind hybrid share is having an addressable pool of storage in the C2 cloud. Meanwhile, the data that you use most frequently can be cached to your local server. This way, your users on site will have fast access to the files that they use most. In an example, you can see, let's say there's 60 terabytes of data in our C2 cloud account. Meanwhile, at our headquarters, we don't necessarily use all 60 terabytes of that data on a daily basis, but let's pretend there's 2 terabytes that our employees rely on for their daily tasks. We can use hybrid share to cache that 2 terabytes on the local server so employees can access it, again, at the speed of our local LAN. Once they make changes to the data, it will sync back to the cloud. Expanding on this, we could add a couple more locations. Let's say we add an office in Germany as well as an office in UK. We can have different sizes of C2 hybrid share data cached at each location. So while our US office may have needed 2 terabytes, our German office might need 10 terabytes of data that they use very frequently. Likewise, our UK office might only need 500 gigabytes. As you can see, having different sizes of Synology NAS and different sizes of hybrid share cache is totally possible because this is a service that's configured on the NAS level as opposed to globally across the entire cloud. In terms of setting up hybrid share, it's extremely simple. If you've ever created a shared folder on a Synology NAS, you'll be immediately familiar with the process. Basically, first thing we'll do is go into Control Panel. And just like we would create a normal share, we can now mount a hybrid share folder. Once we do that, it will prompt us to log into our C2 cloud account. And from here, we'll enter our credentials. We'll see how much space we have available. And then it's going to prompt us for an encryption key. And this is an important step and an exciting step. C2 Cloud does client-based encryption, meaning that the data sent to HybridShare is going to be encrypted by your local NAS before it goes over the internet to the cloud service. This gives you maximum security over your files. And in fact, Synology can't even access your data. So be sure to keep your encryption key in a safe place. Once we've chosen our encryption key, then we're prompted to set some parameters for the HybridShare folder. Let's go ahead and give this a capacity of 300 gigabytes. Once we've got our folder set up, we'll hit next, and it's going to go ahead and create the folder. And you'll see it's going to appear amidst all your other shared folders, just like the rest of them. Now, to your employees, there's no difference in the way this data is viewed. They can map a network drive or browse to the share, and they'll see everything that's in that C2 hybrid share folder living on the C2 cloud right there, just like it was on a local network. As you can see, there's a lot of benefits to hybrid share. For one, you're going to save space on site. You don't have to have your entire archive of data at every location. As you saw in our example earlier, we had 60 terabytes of storage, but we only had 2 terabytes of storage at the local site for caching that data. You can have smaller units across your org. You'll also have offline access. If you do have an ISP that goes down, because the data you're using on a regular basis is cached, it's quite likely your company will be able to continue functioning, stay up and running, even without the internet. And there's less dependence on your headquarters, whether you're using the Synology Drive Sync with HybridShare, or if you're just talking about accessing data from your headquarters, you can now pull data from the cloud in a way that you won't have to tax that ISP and that local bandwidth. You'll have more throughput available for other things. Let's move on now and talk about C2 Directory. Over the years, Synology's had several directory services, including Synology Directory Server and LDAP Server. Now, C2 Directory is our first hybrid directory service, meaning it lives both in the cloud and on-prem. There's several benefits to having a hybrid directory service as opposed to a cloud-based or an on-prem solution. Part of that is the benefits of both worlds. In terms of performance, you get faster performance with hardware on-prem authenticating your users. We did some A/B testing against one of the most popular directory as a service offerings and found that C2 Directory could authenticate about 4 times faster than a cloud-based service. So your users will get much better performance. But there's also the cloud-based management benefits. Because this lives in the C2 cloud and can scale across your entire org, deploying globally is going to be easier than ever before. We've actually built in some new features called organizational units that will allow you as an admin to go in and separate how your regional offices and your regional admins can access the data. You can do partial folder syncing, you can do partial access, however you want to set up your hierarchy is up to you. You can go in and create different organizational units, as many as you'd like throughout the different regions of your company or different locations. And then for each organizational unit, you can specify different administrators, multiple administrators or a single admin. Once you've chosen admins for your org unit, then you can choose which users of your entire directory or domain are going to apply to that org unit. After you've assigned the users to that org, now if you log in as that admin that has access to that org unit, you're only going to see the users and the data that's assigned to you to manage. This is going to be really nice if you are tiering out multiple levels of management over larger deployments with many Synology NAS or thousands of users. If you're using a directory service like Microsoft 365 or G Suite, you'll be pleased to know that C2 Directory supports two-way synchronization with both of these platforms. On top of that, if you're using Synology LDAP or Synology Directory Server, integrating C2 Directory is going to be a breeze. Through a simple wizard-based GUI, you can go ahead and authenticate to whatever service you're joining. In this example, let's look at Microsoft 365, put in our credentials, and then we can begin importing users into our Synology C2 directory. At the bottom here, you notice there's a checkbox that actually gives us a chance to do two-way syncing so that any changes we make in C2 directory will get synced back to that third-party cloud. You can have a ton of different options for redundancy and accessibility as you configure your cloud in ways that you've never done before. On top of all this, C2 Directory supports device management. You'll have granular control over your workstations on both Mac and PC clients. With a simple, lightweight client, which can be deployed en masse, you'll be able to grant administrators access to make controls over the settings on your workstations. This can range from simple things like installing software, like an antivirus software or office software, to even hardware control, like setting up a screen lock or disabling USB ports if you don't want employees connecting other devices to company hardware. As you can see, C2 Directory gives you a ton of different advantages between performance, multi-site configurability, integration into the services that you already love, like Microsoft 365, and managing your workstations. You'll be able to take the way that you manage your org to a whole new level with C2 Directory. The last thing I want to talk about today is Active Insight. Active Insight is a cloud-based monitoring tool with a mantra of predicting and solving problems before they become a serious issue. Now, Active Insight actually lives in the C2 cloud. All of the Synology NAS in your deployment are going to speak to the C2 cloud, giving their diagnostic and constant health information. So you as an admin can then log into Active Insight via a web browser or via a mobile app and get complete data over your entire deployment. The fleet view allows you to see all of the Synology NAS that you've deployed across your entire org and just granularly scroll through and see many different parameters about system health and integrity. There's even advanced smart analytics for hard drive prediction. If you're using Synology hard drives, you'll also have the best control and the best heads up in terms of drive lifespan and being able to proactively swap those out before drives die or be ready to swap them out when a drive does reach the end of its lifespan. You'll obviously have all kinds of hardware monitoring over things, but you'll also get control over activity. So you can see network bandwidth usage. You can also look for things like CPU usage, which brings me to my next point. As an admin, you're in charge of upgrading your IT deployment as the company's need scales and the company grows over time. Active Insight will allow you to set granular notifications and create customized events to make that even easier for you. For example, let's say we want to keep an eye on a new office that's growing and adding more employees. We're concerned whether or not the file server is powerful enough. We can go in to Active Insight and we can actually create a custom event type. We can now set specific criteria, like a threshold of, let's say, 75% CPU usage for a duration of 5 minutes or more. We're going to receive an event notification if this event does get triggered. Then we can even take this to the next level and set a critical level. Let's just use 85% as our critical level. With information and data like this, we can keep an eye and look out for unique performance patterns or if we have perhaps a user that's using the NAS in a way that's not intended, or we can just see as it slowly grows over time, the workload increases, now we know it's time to scale up that unit to perhaps to one of our XS Plus units, one of our SA units, or even a flash station if you need maximum performance. Between all of the bird's eye view features, you're going to get an Active Insight, the ability to log in from anywhere in the world, getting those proactive recommendations, the advanced hard drive analytics, and granular notification controls. As an admin, you'll be able to keep a better eye on your Synology deployment than you've ever been before. That wraps up what I wanted to talk to you about today with Synology Hybrid Cloud. We've got Hybrid Share for cloud-based storage and local caching of the most frequently used data, C2 Directory for your cloud-based and on-prem hybrid authentication services, and Active Insight for monitoring your entire deployment and managing in mass. Thanks for tuning in today. Looking forward to seeing you all in DSM 7.